Well, hello everybody and welcome back to the Hilltop Pillbox here in Abbotsford, British Columbia, Canada. And we are on turn 4.2. This is actually January of 1938. So the war is moving along, although there hasn't been much warring. It's been mostly some posturing and gathering resources and gathering some extra troops, which the Communist Chinese have been blessed. We have done well with that. So we're going to start with them. And we are going to show you what they got. They got a lot of money. So they got $9 here, and they got another $3 here for a cavalry. So three infantry, one cavalry, and they're going to save $1.
And sometimes you just got to save your quarters.
You hit the nail on the head, Elena. In order to build a business, you need to save for equipment you'll need to buy in the future. If you put away a little money at a time, it won't be long before you have enough for the things you need. But if you spend more than you should, you'll find that you don't have any money left when you really need it.
Okay. We have no attacks this turn, of course. All we're going to do is do expanding our influence. And I guess we're going to do our moves first. We've got to do moves. So we're going to grab these two infantry here. They're going to move down into Hope. Right there. And we're going to have a couple of the infantry from Peking come on over as well. They're going to sit in Hope. Never know when those KMT are going to come charging north. A couple of mountain infantry in Shenxi are going to move down into Sichuan. It's a mountain territory there, so we're going to do that. And we're going to have a cavalry join them. And these two infantry in Shenxi are going to also move into Hope. Okay, that's pretty much everybody that can move. We have these guys here. Oh, and I need to mention Hainan. Hainan actually has the same warlord symbol as Kwangtung.
Well, isn't that special?
And I forgot to do that on the last video, and I'm sure some people pointed it out. We haven't posted it yet, so I don't know, but I'm sure somebody will... We'll figure it out. So we are up $1 from where we were. And that's why we can afford so many nice things.
What's this?
This is for you, Clark.
What is it?
Gift.
You really shouldn't.
Oh, those are great, Dad.
Quiet down, Russ.
Turn them on.
No, I don't want to get them dirty.
I told you you wouldn't like them, Eddie.
Okay, so we're just going to do our roll now. And we're going to try to take Singhai. And of course, the roll has to be equal to or less than the number of territories. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 territories to Communist Chinese name. So I need a 7 or less. We're going to use Lucky Red here. Kaboom! Love this thing. Love. And just in case some of you are wondering, yeah, it's got all the numbers. Let me roll it again just for fun. Well, look at that. I better stop. I'm going to need those rolls. Okay. So these folks here are going to go, they've seen the light.
And at last I see the light.
We're going to replace that. I don't have any more cavalry sculpts, so we're kind of stuck there. But I am going to grab some chips here, because I don't think I got room for more infantry. And I can put them anywhere. I believe they can go anywhere where I've got current guys here. Just, you know what, I'm going to pause and make sure. Folks, sorry about some of the mistakes, but again, we are learning the game as we go, and we're having a lot of fun, but I want to get this one right. Give me just a moment.
Why do you suppose I just hurled a chair at your head, Neiman?
I don't know.
Sure you do.
The tempo?
Were you rushing or were you dragging?
I don't know.
Start counting.
5, 6, 7.
In 4, damn it! Look at me!
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now, was I rushing or was I dragging?
I don't know.
Count again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Rushing or dragging?
Rushing.
So you do know the difference.
Okay, good. So I can, and it says any zone that I held before the turn began, and a maximum of 3 units can be placed at a time. So my 3 infantry are going to go into Szechuan, and then the cavalry, this guy, he will go into Shenxi. All right. Now, Xinghai is worth nothing, so my economy will not go up any.
For the next generation, particularly in places like 739 Village, the Chinese miracle is no longer secure as it once appeared.
All right, but right now the economy is at 10, equal to Italy. There you go. That's for Marco Polo, baby. So I'm going to get 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so we got 10 bucks. We'll have 11 to spend with Communist China next round. Right now, actually, my phone's been buzzing a little bit. We've been talking about Lend-Lease. And so we're done with Communist China. So that's cool. But now we're going to do some stuff with the Soviets. Now, Lend-Lease, as you know, you can go from any port that you have to any other port if you're using the water, or just across from on the factory to the first land territory of the country that you are lend-leasing to. So the Soviets here, they've got their $14, so they're going to be buying a mountain infantry and a fighter, and they are going to lend-lease both of these, but they can only lend-lease one unit to any particular country. Well, this fighter is going to be lend-leased all the way from, let's make it dramatic, all the way from Leningrad. Dun, 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 dun. All right, so Leningrad is going to lend-lease this fighter. It's going to, my phone's still beeping. It's going to lend-lease this thing all the way to here and follow this railway down with the blessing of, you can see there's a railway here, with the blessing of the Japanese, and it will land at the first territory, which of course is Peking. Want to make sure we get that right. Okay, so there's now a Chinese fighter in Peking. Okay, now the other lend-lease is at the end of the Soviet turn, so I was going to fly this fighter down, but apparently you can't do that. Apparently that's verboten.
That's impossible!
So we're going to send him back. We'll just send him back to Moscow. He can make it, obviously. So nothing else changes for the Russians. And now we've got a mountain infantry that we are going to try to lend-lease. So he goes in the lend-lease box on the chart, which we won't worry about right now. He's sitting in the lend-lease box, and we're hoping that it will open up after an attack that the Republicans are going to have to make. You can see things are pretty dire. We're in a surrounded city, which means our plus two defense has actually turned into a negative one defense for all the units. So we are going to... Can you hear my phone beeping every time? We are going to charge into Leon Castile. Yes, you heard it here first, folks. He's got two militia, one mountain, a fighter, and a tactical. And I'm coming in with 4 infantry, 2 fighters, and a medium bomber. Now, there is a port here. So should I win, he can then be placed because the port is open. It doesn't say anything in the rules about the port needing to be open the whole time, unless it's buried somewhere in some obscure rule someplace. So this is what we're going to go with. And I am going to just confirm on my phone. Give me a moment. Sorry. Okay, for those of you who were paying attention and you saw a red arrow here, that red arrow has been removed because I can no longer take my fleet up here and try to destroy these nationalist boats. They're the white ones there. Because apparently I can't go through the Danish Straits. Now, it's bad on my part because they were in range last round, and for some reason I thought my heavy cruiser could only move 2. So that's bad on me. I could have easily looked that up and gone and hopefully crushed those things, but we'll find out. But in a fit of angst, I am going to be charging out with the troops from Madrid into Leon Castile. Yes, you saw it here first, folks. The madness of Hilltop Hillbach.
Wait till they get a load of me. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
So, all right, so we've got four infantry. We've got two fighters and one medium bomber, which then provides us, if these guys get hits in the first round, we take away air units. All right, here we go. Come on, get a one. Not two ones. All right, looks like we got two hits with our aircraft, so that'll take away his air power. Now, they do get to shoot back, of course. So they have their fighter at 6, their tactical at 5. I'll turn that like that. We got two militia and one mountain infantry is at 4. All right, here we go. And we have just one hit. One hit with infantry, no hit with air. That is surprising and that is very welcome. But he did get a hit with his militia, of all things. So I will be losing an infantry. Okay, so I am down to 3 infantry, 2 fighters, and a medium bomber. Here we go. Let's get some ones on those yellow dice. Okay, well, we got 3 hits with the other things, so that actually erases his whole force. That gets rid of the 2 militia and the mountain. That's all he had left. So 2 militia and a mountain. So these guys are at 2, and the blue is at a 4. Well, the militia showed up. Gave you a 1. So 1 hit. So I'm going to remove 1 infantry. This is like the worst spot on the table because it's far from everything. All right. So that takes care of that, which opens up Leon Castile. And my infantry goes charging in. And I forgot to, as usual, get a roundel. Now, I don't have their proper Republican and Nationalist ones, so I just put their benefactors on there. And now, the optional rule is that you can use ports and naval air and naval bases that you've just conquered. So guess where all my planes are going? Yes, that's right. We're going right there. And now that we've won that, we are able to then place our lend-lease of our single mountain infantry into Leon Castile. So now I have 3 infantry, 1 mountain infantry, 2 fighters, and a medium bomber. And that is probably some of the luckiest rolling I've had in this game so far. That's pretty amazing that his aircraft didn't get hits on round 1. Okay, well, that's pretty much it, folks. The Soviets didn't do any movements around their country, left everybody where they're at, just kind of chilling, not a lot going on yet. Got some guys up at the front, got some motorized infantry ready to move when they need to, but everybody else is pretty much chilling. So that's it for the commies. That's it for the Soviets and the Republicans in Spain. So thanks for watching, folks. Going to turn you over to Japan. Japan is at turn 4.3. And I don't know if they're getting an itchy trigger finger here. We might see some border clashes. We might see some movements into China. I don't know what he's got up his sleeve here. But whatever happens, it's going to be interesting. So thanks for watching, folks, and we will see you the next Comintern turn. Thanks for watching. So I forgot to do my recruitment roll, and we got to get a 1 or a 2. So high hopes, but low expectations. But we are using our commie die. Yes, this beautiful red die that served us so well. Will it give us another 1 or a 2? Yes! Love it! That's amazing. I have no idea what to build. Okay, just so you know, when this game is done, I'm putting this thing on eBay. The reserve bid is $1,000. I'll buy on eBay what I bought on eBay. Okay, honestly, I just gotta hold on to that territory as long as I can. That's what I need to do. So we're going to build two militia and just hope that we can hold on. And that's... two militia. Now, the question is, well, he can come at me with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units into Madrid. So, granted, he's going to have some, but the militia's only a 2. And it's a tough guess. But I think I just want to exist. I want to exist. I don't want to throw away that role. Good grief. How lucky is that? Okay, so we're going to add that. So now in Leon Castile, we have 2 fighters, a medium bomber, 3 infantry, a mountain, and 2 militia. And then in Madrid, we still have a lone militia. All right, and the other thing I forgot to do was my tech rolls. I even have them all set up. So we're at as far as we can get on the ones that we wanted. And so we're going to try some new stuff here. So we got advanced mechanized. We got strategic rockets and radar. Okay, so 2 7s are the red and the green. The yellow needs to be a 9 or better. So here we go. Okay, well, the green, we got the advanced mechanized. This red die just loves those 1s and 2s. Are you kidding me? It's got to get out a roundel here. So we got advanced mechanized. Keeping pace with the Germans there. So 1 for 3 on that. I'm not going to complain because good night. Some great rolling again for that red die. Get your bids in early, people. Going to be a good one. All right. So that is it now for the turn, I'm pretty sure. So you take care. Thanks for watching. And as I say, here come the Japanese. Got a lot of steel in the water right now. Let's see where it's going.
I knew you were going to forget.
Okay. One last thing. All right. So we're going to move. 1, 2, 3, we're going to move that Navy down there, and the coastal sub will go ahead down there as well. So they've joined the British fleet off the coast of Gibraltar. There you go. I swear, folks, that is it. There's nothing else I'm doing. Even if I wake up in the middle of the night going, I forgot to move. That's okay. Wake up on a Saturday night. Done. Apologies, folks. It's been a crazy day at work, and... My brain is half there, half here, so hopefully that makes sense.
That makes no sense.
Thanks, folks. Let's see what the Japanese do. It should be fun.